coming up on today's episode of AMA Drone Report. DJI adds airplane and helicopter detectors to consumer drones. The FAA announces more access to airspace for drones. And the Academy of Model Aeronautics awards $50,000 in scholarships. Welcome to Airborne's AMA Drone Report, a weekly news program covering the recreational drone world. In partnership with the Academy of Model Aeronautics, one of the oldest and most respected aviation organizations in the world, with more than 200,000 members and 2,400 clubs across the country. I'm Sophie Herlock. DJI will be installing airplane and helicopter detectors in consumer drones as part of a 10-point plan to ensure our skies stay safe in the drone era. All new DJI models released after January 1, 2020, and weighing more than 250 grams, will include AirSense technology, an airplane and helicopter detector. AirSense receives ADS-B signals from nearby aircraft and will show their location on the screen of the drone pilot's remote control, as well as warn them if the two are on a collision course. AirSense has previously only been available on some professional-grade DJI drones. This will be the largest single deployment of ADS-B collision awareness technology to date, and sets a new standard by making professional-grade aviation safety technology available to anyone. Now let's take a quick look at some stories making rounds of the small UAS and hobby drone communities. It's time for today's Drone Minute. The Martin Aircraft Company has closed its doors, put its warehouse up for lease, and liquidation of their assets will be completed later this year. Once called one of the world's top 50 most anticipated inventions by Time magazine, the New Zealand company burned through more than $50 million of its investors' money. Their Jetpack, which used a pair of ducted fans to provide lift and thrust, was overshadowed by nearly 300 companies also developing personal eVTOL aircraft. Vestas has recruited Sulzer Schmid and WKA to carry out an extensive drone-based blade inspection campaign on 1,250 turbines by the end of June. Both companies are in the rotor blade inspection business, and Sulzer Schmid even uses UAVs to complete inspections. All the blades are located across Sweden and Finland and must be inspected in time for the repair work season, which takes place during the less windy summer months. The Fairfax County Board of Supervisors unanimously voted to approve a public safety small UAS program. By delivering high-quality imagery, data, and custom geospatial solutions, the UAS program will give the county's first responders an enhanced level of operational capability, situational awareness, and safety. The 2019 AirVenture Innovation Preview roster is filling up fast, with over half the slots now taken. The AIP is dedicated to showcasing new and innovative technologies to Oshkosh visitors and is open to all AirVenture exhibitors. Slots are first come, first served, so don't miss out on your chance. To be included in this year's AIP, send an email to jim@aero-news.net. Now back to the rest of the news. More than 100 control towers and airports are being added to the hundreds of FAA air traffic facilities and airports that use low-altitude authorization and capability system, or LAANC. LAANC is a collaboration between the FAA and industry that supports safe integration of unmanned aircraft systems into our airspace. The system speeds up the time it takes for a drone pilot to get authorization to fly under 450 feet in a controlled airspace. LAANC provides air traffic control professionals with visibility into where and when authorized drones will be flying near airports. With the addition of contract towers, staffed by private company employees, to the number of LAANC-enabled facilities, drone pilots now have access to more than 400 towers, covering almost 600 airports. LAANC is currently used by commercial pilots who operate under the FAA's Part 107. The FAA will be upgrading LAANC to allow recreational flyers to use the system, but for now those flyers can only operate in a controlled airspace at a fixed site. For updates on LAANC capabilities, head over to faa.gov/go/LAANC. The AMA has helped graduating high school seniors achieve their dreams since 1970, with individual scholarships ranging from $500 to $8,000. This year, a total of $50,000 was awarded to students. The AMA announced 13 graduates from across the nation will benefit from the scholarship this year. Award designations are set by the AMA Scholarship Committee, made up of model aviation pilots and enthusiasts who rank each applicant based on GPA, community involvement, and model flying experience and competition participation. Scholarship money is generated through donations by model aviation organizations, individuals, AMA members, and a portion of AMA dues. More than $1.1 million has been awarded since the founding of the scholarship program. And that's it for us today. For more information on the exciting hobby drone world, check out modelaircraft.org. Have a great day, and I'll see you right back here tomorrow for an episode of Airborne Unlimited.